believe that the story that you tell yourself on a daily basis is what determines the trajectory of your life? And I'm going to say that again because I want you to really consider it. When I'm asking you these questions, I'm really trying to get the cogs turning, get the wheels going. Have you actually contemplating things outside of your comfort zone? So again, the question is, do you feel as though the story you tell yourself about yourself influences or dictates the trajectory of your life? And after you're sitting and pondering this, you're going to come to one of two conclusions, naturally. You're either going to say, no, there's no way. You know, it's circumstance that dictates what my life is like. Or you're going to realize and recognize, whoa, wait a minute. The reason my life has taken the path it has or continues to take the path it has, the reason I'm still feeling stuck exactly where I am right now is because I continue to tell myself a story about who I am, about how my life is. Maybe you've been telling yourself the victim mentality story, that you are a victim of circumstance, of other people's behavior has influenced how your life has gone. Maybe, you know, you're telling yourself the story that you're a victim of where you live or your job or any of these things. The story you tell yourself about you matters. Because if you are telling yourself a story that continues to keep you stuck, like you're worthless, you're not smart enough, you're not good enough, you know, that's, good luck is meant for other people, I'm pessimistic, nothing good ever happens to me, that's just who I've always been since the time I was very small. If that's the story you're feeding your brain, and we've talked about this countless times, and there's a reason I continue to go back to it time and time and time again, because it's probably the most important lesson you'll ever learn. And that is, whatever you program your brain, whatever story you tell your brain, it is going to go out and look for evidence to support that story, therefore allowing it to become a self-fulfilling prophecy. Because if you say, I'm not smart enough, I'm not good enough, the whole world around you will reflect that story. You will be shown time and time again reasons, proof that that is the case. So if we're that powerful, if you are that powerful, let's not even talk about we, if you right there listening right now are that powerful to be able to have that kind of influence on the way your life moves forward, what would happen if you started redefining the story you tell about yourself to yourself and to others for that matter? What would happen if you stopped or became really observant of what you're actually saying about yourself now and decided that's not the story you want to tell about yourself anymore, that you're no longer willing to accept that as reality, that you are actively going to take back control of your life and set forth and reauthor and redefine a new story for yourself? One that is actually something you want to embody. One where you're like, I'm worthy, I'm deserving, I'm smart enough, I can have whatever it is I want. Reality is nothing but a sea of potentiality, and it is my divine birthright to be able to go out and touch it. What if that was your way of thinking moving forward? What if you could alter your story in such a profound way that you could switch things around? Simply by starting this, simply by recognizing the story which you tell of yourself. It's got to start there. You got to know, hey, this is actually the story I'm pumping through my brain and to be able to change it, right? But I'm telling you, once you can reframe and change that story, things start to change dramatically for the better. Things start to move. It's like a snowball. You will start to see results that you want, that are driven by you and inspired by you, not dictated by society, your parents, your community, by your friends, your partner, by anyone else. By you. You get to decide. And the moment you realize you're that powerful is the moment that things begin to change. But sometimes what happens is that before we can get to that part, there's lots of, like, you know, limiting beliefs or like blocks or things that are holding us back, most of which are fear. And sometimes we got to sort through that before you can get to the other side. This is what I do. This is what I'm passionate about. This is what I'm supporting all of my incredible clients with. With redefining their story, but first bashing through and punching through all of those blocks, all of those beliefs that tell you you are nothing but amazing and deserving and worthy. And most of those, I'm telling you, are rooted in fear. So if that is something that you're ready for, that is something that you're ready for right now, I highly encourage you to reach out to me and let me know, Denise, boom, I am ready to start punching through those blocks. It's very therapeutic. Punching through the proverbial blocks. Let me know. Drop a fist down in the comments if you are ready to take back control, rewrite your story, and start living a life that is destined for you, stepping into who you were meant to become. This is my passion. This is what I live for. And I want you to figure out the same thing for yourself. And with that, I hope you are happy, healthy, and abundant. And of course, make it a great day, make it a great day, make it a great day. My sprinkle version. Anyways, let's get to it. I'll see you soon.